Hello, friends. Stay tuned. What's up, everybody? My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. You can call me what you'd like, but it should be Ciotti. We're going to do some building, and I'm figuring out how to start the stream, let YouTube generate the URL, and then grab the URL real quick and put it onto the book filled with faces. So that's what I'm doing right now. While I'm doing that, you guys can enjoy this. Because remember, 諦めんなよ。諦めんなお前。どうしてそこで諦めるんだ。そこで。もう少し頑張ってみろよ。ダメダメダメ。諦めたら。丸のこと思うよ。もう一瞬一瞬のこと思ってるのって。あともうちょっとのところなんだから。俺だってこの前まで柔道だから。信じるが通るって頑張ってんだよ。絶対行ってみろ。必ず目標達成できる。だからこそ。言えばいいんだ。 right, enough of that. So in this amount of time, which looks like 6.5 minutes, I was only able to get it put it up on 3 pages. 3 groups. Facebook is just so slow. Basically. But hey, what's up everybody? Proton to Go is here, Zoning is here, William Barlow, Leaderbuck, Mark Lauper, and Shane Duggar. Shane, you made it, man. How are you? Pauly Lee, good night. What time is it there, Pauly Lee? Jimmy Nature is here. Mike Bergman is here. What's up, everybody? Starting to fill up a little bit. Let me put it in one more group. I gotta get in the habit of doing this. D. What about droops with droops? Great. Groups with the letter D. Nope. None of those make any sense. I also try to put it into groups that have something to do with it. Although, you know what? I should be putting it into I have to put it into Rotor Riot, because if you're not going to put it in there, I mean, just don't even put it anywhere. Alright, let me do that. 7:45 p.m. Why on earth are you going to sleep, sir? You need to stay up until 5 a.m. That's where it's at. That's what you do if you're just a real dummy. I have, as you can probably guess, I have not been able to get my sleeping schedule back anywhere close to normalcy. Solo, it is a horribly rainy, disgusting gray day here. Oh, hey, check this out, too. I put another light here. So one of the problems is when I hold things up, there's not good light here, but I believe to have fixed that. So, like, let's just say I was going to say, oh, look at this, guys. Oh, yeah, that's so much better. That's way better than it used to be. There's the reflection of the light, actually. It's one of those little, it's one of my little, these things. No, you guys can't see it. You guys know what I mean. It's the closet light thing, the strip light. That's pretty cool. And if I turn it off, we'll really be able to see the difference. Yeah, okay. So that totally helps. All right. Slick. That is a good thing. And this is a good thing. There we go. All right. Bizarre. What's going on, Off Axis? What's up, Tiago? Off Axis was streaming a little bit earlier, fixing a 2-inch, it looked like. Mike, are you seriously? Dude, it's bad. It's real bad. Like, last night I went to sleep at 6 a.m. It was actually beyond 6 a.m. because it's just bad. It's really, really, really bad. Off Axis is going out to fly. Pauly Lee says, I got True with Fat Shark. They will send me a new DVR board for HD3. Oh, okay. Right. Nice. That's cool. They took care of you. Solo says, sucks. It's nice down in South Florida. Tuning in for a smoke break. Nice. All right. Let's start doing some work. And I'm going to let music rip just this whole stream. Whatever. Oh, God. Oh yeah, so I want to try something. Well, I want to show you guys. That's what I actually want to do here. I want to just show you guys what it looks like the way that I normally work when I'm not reaching around the camera. Yeah, he said reach around. Just for like a minute or two. So yeah, I don't know. I thought maybe I find myself talking about it a lot, saying like, you know, when I do good quality work, it's when the camera is not poking me in the bosoms. But yeah, I don't know. I just every once in a while I become curious about, is there another camera angle that works better than this? And so we're gonna try it. Let's get this guy a little bit wider. That's better. Even whiter yet. Reach around. Ugh, brutal. Servo actuation. What are you actuating with a servo, Rob?
Okay, so the duo is going to get all the good stuff. This is the new sock sex. So that's the last time I'm going to say that, because I feel like I'm getting, like, flagged and child, you know, the word that begins with P and ends with nography. Yeah, I'm going to stop saying suck sex. I'm just going to call this an iFlight ESC. This is iFlight's $33, I think it is, 35-amp BLLE32 tiny little ESC. So I'm going to run it on this Acrobrat Duo, where I'm going to be doing this motor testing. So this is going to get the hell beaten out of it. And the specs on this thing are beautiful. Tommy Lou, what flight controller? Yeah, the specs on this thing are fantastic. The only thing that might kill it, make it not the best ESC available for micros, is if it's not durable. So that's what I want to try to test. And yeah, I think this is the best platform for that to be tested on, because it's gonna, you know, I'm gonna be putting motors on that are smooth and notchy, and the notchy motors are gonna try to fly away because they're gonna have too many vibrations, and that puts a ton of stress on an ESC. So this will be a really interesting test. What am I looking for? This up here. So I just want to take this off real quick. You know, I don't even need to take it off. I can just lift it up. What's the music? So the music is hovering around like minus 20 dB, and then it looks like my voice spikes up to about 0 dB. So I'm assuming that the audio is okay, the audio mix is okay, but Tommy says it doesn't turn on, only connects to beta. So that sounds a lot like your 5 volt BEC died. Basically, when you plug it into USB, it gets 5 volt through the USB cable, and so when it gets its own 5 volt source, it powers on. But when it's being fed from your ESC, it gets VBAT, which is the full voltage coming out of the battery, which is never 5 volts. You know, it's always 8 or 12 or 16. And so when the flight controller's BEC dies, it can't convert that full voltage coming in to 5 volt to power the board. And yeah, the dead giveaway there is that you said that when you plug it into USB, it connects to Betaflight. So the bad news is you're never going to get current. You're never going to get battery voltage again on that board. Like, that's done. So if you need battery voltage again, you got to buy a new flight controller. The kind of good news is if you can sacrifice battery voltage, you can actually still use that board. What you can do is buy a little $3 5 volt BEC, and then feed that into any of the 5 volt pads on your flight controller, and basically just hooking that up to one of those pads will spread that 5 volt around, I guess you could say. And yeah, the board will fire back up and it'll run. You'll just never get voltage again, because the voltage is done by that 5 volt BEC. So you'll never have battery voltage. But I mean, I've done it before and it's kind of get used to it. It's like the old days where you used to have to fly until you felt the battery sag and then come back in. That's the way all micros were for the first, like, 2 years of me being in this hobby. So right now what I'm doing insanely is trying to bend one of these screws back straight just a little bit here. Because it is rather wobbly. And nobody wants wobbly props or... Wait, no, what is it? What's his name? Wobbly wheels and floppy props. Nobody wants wobbly wheels or floppy props. That's a big no-no. God, come on, straighten out, you fucking screw. Oh, this song just got me fucked for sure. I was hoping that I didn't have any old stuff. Well, shit, this stream is shot to shit. And enough of it has played now where it's gonna... Oh, they got me. They got me, guys. Hey, Mike Bergman. $10 super chat. Thank you, brother. We are gonna add that to the... Ugh, this is fucking Chuck Berry, too. God damn it. Oh, great, let's play another Chuck Berry song. Stop, 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 stop. Oh, even better, Wu-Tang. Great. I'm just going through my, this is my favorites. going into the Rode Wireless GoFund for some better audio. There it is, 167. I know they make extension cables for the Runcam Split 3, but I'm trying to use a Marmot with a Runcam Hybrid 4K while keeping my stack centered. Is there any longer cable option for Runcam Hybrid? Doesn't it come with a longer one? Or am I thinking of the Tarsier? I'm thinking of the Tarsier. It's a really good question. I almost had to do the same. I almost needed a an extension myself. See something real quick. Well, that's not the store. I need to go to the store. There we go. What if I just search their store for hybrid? No. No. Shit, man. That's going to be an email to Runcam. If they don't get back to you, though, I'm going to be pissed. I need to know the answer to that, too. So I'm going to shoot a message to Ada? Might be Ada? Shit. What if I search my chat for Runcam? Maybe that'll... Damn. Nope. How on earth am I gonna find... Let me see. Tommy Lou says, my flight controller... Oh, you only get a month out of the flight controllers, Tommy? Yeah. Try the Talon F4 or F7. I've had really good luck with them. I had the same issue. I've had the same issue the whole time I've been in the micros, is that the components just suck donkey balls. Yeah, the stuff down below in my description is the stuff that I've actually found to be somewhat reliable. So, yeah, check it out. What's up, Eric? How are you, man? How am I gonna find... Oh, search messages. There we go. That's gonna get it. Load more. Here we are. Okay. And come on, please, 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 please find it. Ah, there it is, Claire. It's Claire. Claire is at Runcam. That's who it is. All right, shooting Claire a message. Cable option for the Runcam Hybrid or replacement lenses.
Look, I'm gonna use the light. Yeah. Your boy needs replacement lenses already. I only technically need this top one. The bottom glass didn't break. I mean, it's the FPV cam, so who gives a rat's ass anyway? But yeah, I needed to message her anyway, and this reminded me of that. So, thank you, sir. Ooh, this is a good jam. I am keeping well, weirdo. Alright, back to work. Mike, you're gonna have to remind me that I asked her. I'm not gonna remember that I asked for you. You know what I mean? So just bug me. And plus, I'll bug her. It's been quite a while since I talked to Claire last, so she probably won't, like, remember me or put me in any kind of priority. Which is stupid. I haven't asked her if she wanted to be if she wants to do anything for the giveaways in the stream. So yeah, this will be good. This will kind of open that up. All right, so just really quickly, I wanted to show you guys the full build, and I just want to really quickly solder a race wire to this guy. You guys weren't aware of the time. Alright, turning this back down. Insta360 Go is still in one piece, mainly because I haven't flown it much. I don't want to break it, so I'm not flying it. It's actually, I accidentally left it in my buddy Patrick's P. Ross Scott. No, P something Scott here in the chat. I left it in his car last time we went out flying. Rotten Tomato, T-Motor 3140s are my favorite 3-inch M5 mount prop. They are fantastic. They're one of the very few decent 3-inch prop options. Why is this wire so fucking there? Jesus. Okay. Cut this down a little bit. I'm also gonna go past this song because I really don't want to hear that right now. Oh, this is much more like it. Some lettuce for that ass. Oof. Those lettuce boys, man. They'll keep you healthy. You listen to this a couple times a day, you'll be a healthy son of a bitch. Oof. I'm sorry, but if you don't nod your head to this, you're dead inside. Bring that back down. Yeah, a little bit more. Oof. God, man, where'd it go?
Here it is. Alright. Let's do some goddamn work. You move over there. Kind of side-mounted battery pad setups that I really do like, because you can run it at, I didn't do it here, but you can run the flight controller sideways and, keep the battery pads inside the frame, which is kind of cool. If you do that, I definitely suggest race wires, and like I did here. And yeah, it's you can just run this. If you want the lightest possible setup, you run this out the side, and then you just run this this XT30 and the big fat leads as short as possible, and then you just boop, plug like pretty much right into it. It's a really strong connection because it's soldered to the like thickness of the PCB, so yeah, it holds on pretty good. So you still want to try to strain relief it, but if you can't, it's usually not a big deal. All right, so I'm sure that camera angle blows, so let me get it corrected here. Too many windows open, guys. Too many windows open. There we go. Okay. Rob cooked his fingers resoldering a USB connection using his phone as a microscope. I love when I'm like doing something janky and the world like makes me pay for it. Yeah. It's hard to be actually mad when you're balancing your phone like on your left hand to try to use it as a, yeah. It's good stuff. Oh Christ. Those are always the moments that, like, as I'm burning myself, I'm like, yep, uh-huh, yep, that's what's happening right now. This is gonna hurt tomorrow. What's up, Super Lux? How are you, brother? Weirdo says, opinion on Matek 40-channel HV-VTX. I'm at a point with VTXs where I only buy Immersion RC, Rush Tank, or TBS sometimes. Typically Immersion RC though. I don't have a real reason to stray into a VTX that's not tested. You know what I mean? Like by people. So yeah, I'm just keeping it simple and sticking with the, I mean, is there something special about it? Or is it just another VTX by another company? Know what I mean? Okay, so I'm doing something slick here. Popping the, that was one of the reasons why I pulled it apart like this. So I could pop, oh, you guys can't see. Man, this camera is so close. When it's close, it's so close. Sticking this tiny LED light right through one of those holes in the frame. That's why I soldered it onto the bottom of the ESC, right? So that the wire can just hang out there, right? I'm gonna just pull this guy through. I wish that I had... I'm actually gonna do that now. I'm gonna put a big glomp of shrink wrap around this, I think. But yeah, by soldering it to the bottom like that, it just kind of disappears, right? See what I mean? And a little bit of extra wire can just hang out under there, that's fine. And yeah, so check this out. Look at the packaging I've done here. This is true. You guys are getting to see the true madness. I still have to put a capacitor on this ESC, but look at this. Look at this cleanliness, boys and girls. Mainly boys. Look, right? And then I reran the so it's an RxSR on the bottom, and then it's a tiny tank right on top of it there. And I reran the wires to one side because I realized the RxSR pin header is offset. And when I ran them differently, now the RxSR actually drops down into this hole in the frame, like, perfectly. Hold on, it's like a tight fit. It's hysterical. There it goes. Look at that. Isn't that crazy? And like, it's happy in there. Like, it's totally cool being in there. So I'm just gonna then run a zip tie across. Isn't that crazy? Look at that. If I depinned this RxSR, it would lay completely flat in there, which is just outrageous. Yeah, and then I'm just gonna stick the LED right on there like that, right on the bottom of that guy. Look how clean that is. Oof. That's so clean, it hurts. It hurts me. Yeah, I'm gonna throw a thing of shrink wrap around there, though. Patrick says, did you see Kebab's 2203 motors? Not only did I see them, Patrick, but I ordered them about an hour after he put them up. as well as the Cineglide. So, yeah. Chris, so... I've been involved with a film company called Octopunk Media, run by a really good friend of mine, Michelle, who I met through tabletop games, actually, in Charleston. Tabletop as in, like, board games. Not, yeah. On here, on YouTube, if you search tabletop, you'll find Will Wheaton's show called Tabletop, which is fantastic, but fair warning, you'll probably end up getting into board games after watching a bunch of it. but it's actually really nice. It's there are some incredibly fun board games, and it's just a really, like, tactile... It's kind of a douchey word, but it's a thing that you're doing with your eyes in three dimensions and with your hands, and it's just really nice. This might just be me... being about to be 40, but I don't know. It was very, very fun. We met some really cool people too. The people who play board games are really cool people. They're kind of like perfectly nerdy, but really smart and just really nice people. I don't know. We just met some... I think we met more, like, lifelong friends through that than anything else in all of the 5 years we were in Charleston. Patrick, what do you mean? Who's gonna sell out? Oh, they're already sold out. I thought you were saying sell out like a negative thing, because my brain always goes negative first, because depression blows. But yeah, they're sold out. I think everything is sold out already on there. I believe that everything that he got in is sold out. The other really good news is I finally remembered to put in the order notes, hey Jason, please throw in... 16, I need 16 now of the lock nuts, so I'll be able to get all the glides back up, and one of them will have the Flightwino stuff. But I'm actually going to drag my feet on that a little bit, because... So my main problem with Kiss was bounce back. And Krunked and I were talking about it the one night earlier this week, and he was saying how he just doesn't ever get it or see it. And he talked to a buddy of his about it, and his buddy was saying the same thing, that like there's no bounce back ever in Kiss. I'd mentioned to him that like the bounce back, not only was it the reason that I went away, the big reason that I went away from it, but it's why Schizo went away from it. And Vic also even mentions it in one of his trick tutorial videos. I believe it was the inverted yaw spin, maybe, trick tutorial. It was one of his more recent, maybe from like a couple months ago, trick tutorial videos. He mentions bounce back, and he flat out says Kiss doesn't handle bounce back well. You just have to retrain your thumbs and fly around it. And I think even on one of the streams around that same time that I'd mentioned that and said, like, you know, that perfectly sums up why I fly Betaflight, because I don't want to fly around it. Like, I feel that Betaflight does a better job than any of the other firmware by quite the margin at targeting specific problems like bounce back, like throttle set, or like the delay, or like tracking set point, which is what feed forward is really good at doing. Like I'm just giving examples of the things that Betaflight has implemented to attack specific flight problems, but yeah, to me and in my experience, Betaflight just does a better job at that, and that's one of the big reasons that I prefer it. And so we're having this whole big conversation, and then he mentioned that, you know, he just doesn't see it, he doesn't get it, whatever. And he'd also said that he thinks that a lot of pro pilots fly around a lot of stuff. And like by the end of the conversation, he had me convinced. I was like, yeah, you know what, you're probably right. I'll probably build this Flagmino rig, and it won't have any bounce back. Because again, you know, even though I remember there being a lot of bounce back, that doesn't really mean anything to me, because I really, like I kind of say all the time, I really try to, kill any, just assume that I'm wrong, basically. Assume that there was bias, assume that when I did the testing, you know, there was something else going on. And incidentally, this is, that sort of attitude is what makes science so accurate, for the record, for anybody that's still doubting science. So as a scientist, the dream is to discover something. And half of that is discovering something brand new, but the other half of it that they're shooting for is to prove something wrong that already exists. So science, by its very nature, checks itself, and it's why it works so well, and it's why that it's so important. But he messaged me the next morning, and he said that he talked to a bunch of other KISS people, and they were all like, yeah, of course it bounces back, it always has. And he said that he was going to reach out to Felix, who is like the guy for, he's the Preston of KISS, but it's, Falco X is basically... it's Willard and it's Preston, but KISS, from what I understand, or Flyduino, is just... Well, no, not Flyduino. Flyduino is the hardware company. KISS is the software. It's just Felix, from what I understand. One-man kind of shop. Krunk said that they were able to get in touch with him, and he's going to try to put something in to handle the bounce back. So that's what I'm going to wait for, to do this build, because... now that, you know, it's kind of confirmed that it does exist, if I do this build, I'm going to put it together and fly it and go, yeah, it flies great, but it's got bounce packs, so I'm not going to fly it anymore. You know what I mean? So, I'm going to drag my feet on the Fetech build, because it's I just know exactly what it's going to be. It's going to be the exact same experience that I already had with Kiss. And if it was better, even with the cost, if Kiss was significantly better, I would be running it, like, for real. It's not that much more expensive, and if I legitimately thought that it would be a way for me to get more performance, right, like a performance advantage, I would do that, because that's, like I've mentioned a lot, you know, being, like, the best as a pilot is something that I'm chasing. Obviously, I'll never be the best, but you know what I mean.
So, yeah. Super Deluxe, I've never done... Well, I have done 3D. The very first quad that was... peer-reviewed studies, exactly. The very first quad copter that I got was a line of sight Blade Nano 3D, and it was 3D, and I could just never get it. I could just never fly it properly in 3D. It was just too hard. There were too many other things going on with yaw and pitch and roll. What I've seen of the 3D stuff, like, there are moments where I'm kind of intrigued by it, but it never seems to flow, in my opinion. I've never seen 3D that has made me go, ooh, I want to learn that because it'll help me. Ow, son of a bitch, that hurt. It'll help me do X, Y, or Z, you know, within whatever the hell flow that I've got going on to make things better. It always just seems a little bit awkward and, like, I don't know. It never feels natural to me, and I'm constantly trying to make my flying look natural. Really early on in my flying, when I started to get more and more thrashy, when Kristen would watch it, she would, like, get vertigo from it. And I don't just want pilots to be able to watch what I'm filming. So that has always been, like, the benchmark. And I will always try to stay below that benchmark so that, like, anybody can watch it without getting vertigo. And the 3D stuff, in some weird way, like, when it comes on, I'm always like, and that might just be because I'm not used to it, but I don't know, I feel like when you're going upside down towards the ground and you all of a sudden, like, it's just kind of like, wait. Which, although now as I say it, I like that moment of holy shit. I don't know. If it gets better to the point where there's less of a notch when it goes from positive to negative, like with Zoe's quad. Zoe's got those super secret squirrel shit motors that don't have that abrupt pickup. Then I'll think about it, but I can't imagine losing half my throttle resolution. That's the one of the other big things for me is that I spend a lot of time, like, practicing really fine throttle resolution so that I can do that shit where I flow, like, fly, like, a couple inches off the ground and just stay there. I don't know. Oh, yeah, that's such a... can my grandma watch this test? Yep, that's the way Travis puts it. It's, like, the perfect... I forgot that he said that. Yeah, it's the perfect verbalization of it. William asks, what are your thoughts on the new Kebab motors? I'm trusting him. I messaged him this before I ordered them. I said I thought that he was doing 2003s. So when they popped up, I messaged him. I said 2203? With, like, a question mark, and I said, I'm gonna trust you on this one and get these before they're gone. And he was like, yeah, they're good. Right now, I think it's too much. I think 22 is too much. Mainly because these 1803 X-Nova motors are so
fucking good, and that's an 1804. I think I might have just said 1803. It's not. It's an 1804. So I'm very skeptical of these 2203s, but even if... So I'm going to head-to-head them on the Cinesplore with the X-Nova 1804s. And right now, what I think is going to happen is going to be that the 1804s are lighter and they're just as good. I just don't think that we need a 22mm wide stator for a 3-inch prop. I could be totally wrong, and I kind of hope that I am wrong, because if I am wrong, then it feeds into what I've always said, that we want wide fucking motors. That this, like, you know, 1408 bullshit has got to stop, and we want these really, really wide motors. Stator, I've always preached that stator width is everything, and like a motor with a lot of stator width feels amazing and has this instantaneous mechanical torque control over the prop. So I hope I'm wrong, but I don't know. 22 seems like so much width for a 3-inch prop, right? If it is, I'll just take them off and I'll put those on a lightweight 5-inch build, because they'll be perfect for that, like a super lightweight 5-inch build. A 2203 would be beautiful on. Or, Christ, maybe even a lightweight 6-inch build, come to think of it. Like a 6-inch toothpick, or even a 7-inch toothpick. Even an 8-inch toothpick, maybe even a 9-inch toothpick. Ah, fuck it, we'll go 10-inch toothpick with them. That's what we'll do. Oh, God. Rob Axelson says, "Depin it, I dare you." Rob, have you depinned them? If so, can you think of a harder thing that you've ever soldered? I believe that that's the hardest, is depinning and then soldering wires to an RxSR. I think that's the smallest pads out of anything I've ever done. No, it's not. The Newbie Drone prototype brushless board, where I had to solder to the little pads where the plug headers are supposed to be, that was harder. Yeah, Mike Bergman, me too. I ordered them at like 3 a.m. I was awake anyway, but I kept checking. Actually, the reason why I caught it is because of the Patreon email. So here you guys go. Here's a great way that Bob used Patreon. He made a Patreon post saying, "Hey guys, the new stock of stuff is going up." If you guys don't know, FPV Cycle sells out of stuff constantly. he can't find manufacturers that can make stuff fast enough. So yeah, all of his patrons got an email saying, "Yo, the new stock is going up," and it went up at like 2 a.m., right? So like, be people's patrons. Patreon is the shit. Do it. Super Deluxe is building an Umagod remix for 3D as we speak. Why'd you pick? Is there? I'm trying to. I feel like that it's kind of a good frame for 3D. It's got like the camera protection on top. Did you pick that frame on purpose for 3D? If so, well done. That's I'm fucking intrigued, man. Zach sent me a message on Facebook. Zach, which, would you send it to my personal page, or, if it's something on Marketplace, I want to let you know right now. Ah, farts. Oh, remix. I thought you said Acrobrat. Yeah, shit, right. That makes total sense. Although, I think a remix ends up being a little bit bottom heavy. I'm kind of convinced that that the Alien style frame with the 160 gram battery and the 80 gram session, I feel like that ends up being perfectly centered on the prop line. I wish there was a way to measure that.
I guess you could just use like fishing line to measure that. This is, we're going from Acrobrat V1 to Acrobrat Duo. I am looking for the message from someone. Off axis, hit me with some really good 3D FPV. I'll play it on the stream. Personal page, mode 2 shredder 5-inch. In your message it didn't come through. But you're saying it's a, I mean, the TBS Source 1 is definitely good. I have heard of Mode 2, though. They've been around a while. I think they're more of a West Coast frame company, so we don't see them much. Let me see, though. That's a cool-looking frame. I'm kind of over the, like... Like the Source One and the Glide, I'm just kind of like, why get anything else? You know, I know that seems like super boring and whatnot, but like, there are just so many advantages to going with a frame that's well established that has a huge aftermarket. It's the same thing with cars. It's what makes Miatas and Mustangs so amazing, is that they are arguably the two cars with the, two rear-wheel drive cars with the biggest aftermarkets. And it's all about the aftermarket with us, right? Like, we're doing everything aftermarket in this hobby too. So it's kind of like, it's that chassis. Oh, there we go. Now that was weird. The picture just showed up. Yeah, it's also got that big-ass chunk of TPU on the front, which, like, TPU is awful heavy. And I don't know how that's going to do in, like, big hard crashes. I'm not down with that whole TPU in the front thing. I don't think the Evo aftermarket's that big at all, Mike. They didn't make enough of them, you know? They didn't make 11 billion of them, here in the U.S. at least. $32 is pretty cheap, but, I mean, fuck, I would go with a glider, a Source One. I gotta be honest. I'm just boring like that though. I would, I really view the frame as just like the chassis. Just get something that's clean and kind of uninteresting, but that works really good, right? Yeah. Oh God, no, not enough with the songs that'll definitely be copyrighted. If the stream just shuts off, it's because a little bit earlier. Oh, where the hell is it? A Chuck Berry song came on a little bit earlier. So if the stream just shuts off and disappears forever, that's yeah. You guys know what happened. Look for the picture in the news of me in handcuffs for copyright infringement. That's how it works, right? They come and get you. All right, so we're gonna make a little, I have run out of waffle caps, so we're gonna slum it and make a set of leads here for a little 330 UF 35 volt capacitor. So first we want to really tin these guys up. Like, you want to get as much solder into the wire as possible, because the leads on the other light's gone. There it is. The other side of this is going to be the leads on the stupid thing. Why can't I think of the word? Capacitor, there it is. Jeez. And yeah, it's just a pain in the ass. And also, don't forget your shrink wrap. You're going to want to shrink wrap over the posts on the lead. So
let's tin the bejesus out of these guys. Or let's push the button on the soldering iron to get the heat back up.
You know, either or.
Tiago, you have no idea how bad I wanted to steal one of yours. I was like, because I meant to order quantity two, and I just completely forgot. And when I opened your bag of stuff, I was like, fuck, he got waffle caps, that son of a bitch.
Oh, God. No, they're too expensive for me to steal them. They're a dollar each, dude. That's ridiculous. Just on general principle, I won't steal one of them.
Those things are fucking gold, man. Plus, somebody just got them back in stock. I think Pyro just got it back in stock. And they do. They technically speaking, this is the lighter way of doing this anyway. So, yeah. With the whole micro lightness thing, that is kind of my deal. I've up until this point only used the waffle caps on 5-inch rigs, and it was just so funny because I kind of looked at this. I was like, man, I'm kind of feeling lazy. I don't want to have to solder directly to the post, but it's really not that bad. I mean, you guys are about to see it. It's really not bad. Like I said though, you just see how it got like a nice big blob on there. That's what I want. I want to try to get a blob hanging off of the wire. And there's, I don't usually do that, so I don't really have a good method of doing it. Although it seems like if you just keep pouring more and more onto the tip of the soldering iron, it'll just naturally leave a bigger blob on there. So yeah, we got two blobby wires. Now, what I do with these little nubbly guys a lot of times is I'll just put this here. You guys can't do this unless you get this thing. I should have a link to this thing though down below, I hope. It's on Amazon. It's like 20 bucks. And this one is broken. Normally these are the little gorilla arm guys with the little alligator clips. I have two of these things now. The one of them broke. Brad actually broke it. It was when we were living in Charleston, and the little alligator clippy things, he grabbed it by the, I was always really careful because the little alligator clip things that it come with are super shitty and cheap and like, you know the ones, these ones, right? Like if you, and yeah, these are particularly cheap on this from, it's the only bad thing about it. This guy from Amazon. And yeah, I meant to tell Brad that because I knew he was gonna be using my gear. And after he left, I saw that the one was all twisted, like he tried to fix it, but it was all twisted up and mangled. And I was like, fuck, I forgot to tell him. I forgot to tell him to be careful because they're like incredibly thin metal. So yeah, now I have two. One of them that works, and then this one. But I realized that it would be nice to have this one without those arms hanging off of it, because it's just great to have a little piece of wood. And yeah, I've drilled a couple holes in it. These two holes are specifically spaced for an XT30, so you can stick an XT30 down there, and it just makes working on it easier. And then yeah, just the wooden surface is just, yeah, it's nice. So I have to choose which way I'm gonna bend this now. So I think I'm gonna put it in the back here. I think I'm gonna zip it up to this, right above this standoff. So that means I want positive on the left. And that's how this thing is sitting right now. So I wanna bend them away. But actually, I don't want to bend them so flat. I want a little bit of a gap in there. So let's try this. Just so that there's a little bit of room for the shrink wrap to kind of get up in there is my thought. And I am very careful with these guys, because these will break, and when they break, it comes apart and comes back together, and that resets the ESC and the flight controller, and you come tumbling out of the sky. So it actually does matter. Be really careful with these things. Try to keep the bends, you know, like the way that I had this in there, and try not to bend it. Like, I don't want to have to bend this back again, but I want to get a little bit more of a gap in here just to really round it out, right? Like, try not to crease this metal. It don't like it. Which is one of the reasons why the waffle caps are actually really nice, is because you then just run these straight up to the waffle cap, and then actually, I'm gonna start shrink wrapping the waffle cap on, because I had one of the waffle caps pop up, and it did exactly that. It broke this off inside of there, and it fell out of the sky. Super Deluxe with $4.20, and of course the comment is Subaru for the win, because all Subaru guys are potheads, and they all wear backwards baseball hats. Flat brims. No, wait, not backwards baseball hats. Wow, I'm an old son of a bitch. I am not even remotely cool. That was the most dad thing I've ever fucking said. Oh, man. Get off my lawn, you backward baseball cap wearing sons of bitches. 4 plus 167. 8, 9, 10, 11. Got it. 171. Thank you, Super Deluxe. You are the man. We are almost there. Can we get there tonight? Oh, hey, every stream from now on, there's going to be a giveaway. How many are in here? 44. Okay. As long as streams get to 40 people, we're going to do a giveaway. It's going to be all like gear that I've run before. So Cool Coyote, I don't switch microphones anymore. I keep it on the same microphone because the microphone over here sucks and it sounds like muddy shit. What I have set up is, if you add the same audio source twice, you can set one of them as your like loud and one of them as your quiet, and yeah, so I can set each scene up with the same mic but at different gains. Ha! How about that? Oh, and vapes, right, I forgot about vapes. Thanks, Super Deluxe. Yeah, vape ripping, flat brim wearing, pot smoking Subaru guys. Zach Barnes, howdy, watching while I grill steaks and asparagus. Oh, you son of a bitch, Zach. Steaks and asparagus on the grill. Kristen just got very upset. We've lived in, Kristen loves to cook, but we've lived in apartments that don't have, like, that have external grills, but they look like God had diarrhea or something. They're just, oh, just cesspools of filth and bad decisions and, oh, so yeah. Brian Ladmiral says Blue Tack works fine for Waffle or Waffle XT30. Blue Tack? What do you mean? What do you mean Blue Tack? 20 quid for a glorified bit of wood. Yeah, very, very much so it is, weirdo. But, well, no, it'd be 10 quid, right? Because it's $20. See that? Or no, it'd be like 12 quid, right? Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I just, like, it had the gorilla arms, and it was, like, well-made, and it was just like, I'll fucking support this guy. This guy, like, it's, when you see it, you're like, oh, it's very obvious that it's just, like, a guy. Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes it's just like, fuck it. I'm gonna support somebody else. I'm gonna support an individual. Handmade stuff is always like, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm down. Brian Ladmiral also offered the 2203 two minutes after Bob messaged us, so you're using them on the Cineglide. Yep. Oh, you're going to put them on a squirt? Okay. Thought you also mentioned the Cineglide. Was that the Cinesplore? Yeah, Cinesplore. That's... I haven't gone down the Cinewhoop path yet because
I really don't have anything to film with it. Like, I haven't had a moment where I was like, ooh, a cinema would be perfect for this. But now I kind of do. Perfect segue back to what I was starting to talk about. Blue Tack instead of this. I gotcha. I thought you were saying Blue Tack, to hold the waffle cap on or something. I was like, what the fuck? Yeah, we have Blue Tack here. So, yeah, my friend Michelle, she runs, you guys should check it out. It's Octopunk Media, right? Yeah, it's here on YouTube. Octo, like octopus, O-C-T-O, and then punk, like punk, and then media, like media. she is an independent filmmaker who I met long ago, and we've kept in touch, and when she was growing up, she loved making movies, but then she stopped because she got into biology, right, honey? Molecular biology, I think? Yeah, she was in, like chemicals and plastics and like, incredibly smart. A legit scientist. Like, she's a straight-up scientist.
Her and her husband.
Yeah, right, too. Her and her husband. It's amazing, and they're both awesome people. And, so, yeah, she started, she got back into filmmaking when she got burned out of being a chemist. That's what she was. She was a chemist. And now she has Octopunk Media, and it's just awesome. Like, I've gotten to, both Kristen and I have gotten to see that whole, what am I doing? I meant to cut this. We've gotten to see the whole thing kind of explode. And so there's a game called Detroit The Awakening. There are 44 of you in here. Have any of you guys heard of Detroit The Awakening? Oh,
Detroit,
right.
Awakening is
her
movie.
Detroit Becoming Human is actually the video game. Yeah, so it's a shame. I wish that the video game was bigger to the point that Kristen and I would have found it and been fans of it. But yeah, it's a really cool video game. What do they call those? What are they, role play? Yeah, choose your own adventure role-playing style. She made this short film 3 years ago?
Yeah.
3 or so years ago that I lit, and it just exploded. And her company has exploded along with it, and it's pretty awesome. She is in my continued work with her. We've got some stuff coming up, and I'm gonna have a Cinewhoop on the set. And if it's scripted in, awesome. If she just wants to play around with it, that's cool too. But yeah, I'm going to do both lighting and flying on a small film set, and it'll be great. I've always done the lighting thing with her. Not always. I've missed a couple projects of hers, but I've been able to do the lighting on most of her projects, and it's just a blast. And I'm just doing this all out of order. Jeez. So yeah, that was cool. Kristen was, so I missed her most recent film because I had just started at my job with Benefit Focus. But Kristen was able to make it and do hair and makeup. And this morning, Kristen was on Michelle's Twitch stream to answer crowd fan questions about the hair and makeup that she did. And after that, we kept the Zoom call going and talked about future projects. So that'll be cool. I will, I'm very much looking forward to that. This is the first, like, on the last film, I kinda, sorta,
had some semblance of how to fly, but I was nowhere near good enough to, and I didn't even offer it to her. But yeah, I was nowhere near good enough to be flying around a crew or a film set or anything like that. So it wasn't even an ethos back then. But now I would feel completely comfortable, and I'm trying to go that route. I'm trying to figure out a way to make money flying, because that's the thing I like the most. But fly things that are interesting. The whole real estate thing strikes me as a good way to kind of ruin it, and I don't want to do that.
Let me scroll up, because I think Detroit Become Human. Yep, that's it. Is it PS4 only off axis? I thought it was cross-platform. But yeah, that's it. Detroit Become Human. It's a beautiful game, and if you get into it and you like it, there are two amazing fan films now free to watch. The first one of which I ran all of the lighting on. We filmed it over a 7-day period.
No, listen to this, because you would not believe it. The first movie.
Come closer.
The first movie we did in.
Louder.
One day.
Oh fuck, that's right.
This last one we just did in 7. So next time she's thinking it's gonna be like
right.
2 weeks.
It was that project in between that was 5 or 6 days.
Yeah. But.
Let me make sure I didn't miss any. Orange. Are you kidding me, y'all, man? Half of the pilots in this hobby are potheads. Yeah, you're in good company there, y'all, man. Just go. I mean, not that it's a bad thing. I don't want this to come off as a negative thing. It's a hysterical thing. But watch Doug's stream, Buckgrinder streams Friday nights. Not the entirety, but probably 90% of the chat will be fellow potheads for you, brother. So you'll be in good company. All right, scrolling back down. Mike Bergman says, "Oh, is that right? You like flying for money, Ken?" I want to figure it out. Super Deluxe with the $28 super chat. Fatality. I'm guessing I don't have to do the math because you said fatality. Oh Christ, I've been on the wrong scene this whole time. Sorry, guys. I'll flip the scene and I'll show you what I did. $28, I'm assuming the math works out to bring it to $199. Look at us go. My friends, it happened.
Go, 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 go.
And that means this is gonna happen. Because the white one, son of a bitch, it sold out. there was like one left of the white one. But black might be a better color anyway, just for trying to make it disappear. Super Deluxe, you're the man. Much appreciated, brother. So yeah, I guess we'll go with the black one. Where is the items like it? Oh! I see what you did there, Mike. Oh, shit. I'm not even going to go back. If somebody has the link, the unlisted link to it, do me a favor and throw it up in the chat, but I don't think I have it. Brian Ladmerall says, just throwing this out there, have a brand new Rode Wireless Go I never use. I would trade for miscellaneous quad gear. Could use the RWG fund for something else. Fly all the same stuff. Done, Brian. Yeah, cool. Do me a favor, message me on Facebook, if you can, at either my personal page or on CIDFPV, and yeah, for sure, man. I have so much stuff for the giveaways that I'm certain that there's a whole bunch of stuff that you may or may not need, or I'll just PayPal you some bucks for it. Dope! Cool. So that's cool, because now I can dive into lav mics. Well, screw it. I'll just take advantage of the collective and say, Brian, what lav mic should I go? I know that Rode has a $70 lav mic that
I believe it's set up to also plug into your phone, which is kind of nice. I would love that capability. But yeah, you tell me what I should get in terms of lav mics, because you probably know way better than the half an hour of research that I would do on forums and Amazon. So we're going to change this to... Shit, there was just something. There was just something that I wanted to... we'll backfill the Cinesplore. Yeah. Cinesplore. We will, yeah. Here we go. Cinesplore. W/... What are they? 2203s? What an asinine motor size. Oh my god. They better be good, Bob. I know you're not... I know you don't watch these, but they better be good. Nice, off-axis. I didn't even know there was a demo. The demo is 14 gigs. Yeah, it's a big, beautiful game, dude. It's gorgeous. We had our work cut out for us trying to make real life... somewhat sell it. But we did our best. I think we did good. Light 5-inch build. Yeah, that's what they might end up. We'll see. They'll find a home for sure. Look at this area here, guys. Look at that. You could hide like a chapstick up in there. See if I can hide my allergy pills up there. Almost.
I do have a chapstick.
Almost. God, I'm starting to look homeless, man. I gotta get this shit figured out. It's like the world's weirdest game of chicken that I'm playing with my hair. Cinesplore. Oh wait, no, I can just look in my email and just look at the order title. Order total. That's the... Oh, I could totally pull off a fro pic. Post grill picture? Oh boy. I'm not gonna do it because I'm kinda hungry, Zach, and I'm trying to stay on here for a while. So I'm gonna look at it when I'm done streaming. And I have a chance of getting some food. Where is my order from last night? Yesterday. Oh no, I guess it was 2 days ago. Yeah, it was 2 days ago. No. It was last night, wasn't it? Where's the goddamn... Oh, I put it in the FPV. Look at me being a... Wow. Oh no, that's not it. Where's the email? This is great television here. There it is. So... Okay, so I got some extra ducts, of course, right? Because I know me. So that's $7. Battery for it, that's 20. Where is it? There it is. Cinesplore frame is 46. I gotta get the calculator out for this. It's just not happening. It's just... I'm not going out like that. 46 plus, I think I said 7, plus I think I said 20... I'm really hoping that it'll run on 3S1300s, because I have four of them. But I got one of these 1000mAh batteries just to see. And then the motors, of course, are expensive. But I did get five of them, because, again, I know me. Even with ducts, I'm pretty confident that I can destroy them. Oh, we did it! Okay, alrighty. So 176, we already did it. Well, then we'll just do the entirety of this order, which after... I got some cool stuff for the giveaways on this order. I'm very tempted to do a build with some of the stuff that I got, but it's for the giveaway. It's for the giveaway. So I'm just going to go with the order total, which was 210 after shipping. So that'll be our new gear fund target. So we're at 199. We didn't... We didn't get much distance out of that, but hey. Since a unique and wonderful used Rode Wireless Go popped up magically because the collective is real. Yeah. Ah, that's Mike Bergman. That's what I was referring to. I'm so tempted to build it, but like, no. Super Lux says, your Italian fro looks like mine, dude. It's crazy. I usually keep it quite a bit shorter than this because it just gets so out of control, but this is my chance, man. My freshman year of college, I let it grow out the entire year, and it was huge. It was like, I could put like a pencil into it, and it would hide almost the whole pencil. It was mega. Yawman Flight says, you should do a video where you're standing there talking and then all of a sudden a tiny whoop comes flying out of your hair. So, Yawman, I've got, last time I did an order on tinywhoop.com, they sell a ton of different hair protection things. And so this is the full, so when back in the brushed whoop days, I got it stuck in Kristen's hair twice, right? The second time wasn't nearly as bad. The first time was pretty... the first time took me like 45 minutes to get everything out and like everything untangled and everything. So yeah, on the last one... Well, so I got this for Kristen, but I have to fucking wear it now because my hair is to the point where I think it'll get all tangled up. But the thing is, the brushed whoops really pulled the hair in because the prop was on the little shaft going into the can. The brushless whoops don't seem to really pull hair in the same way, so I don't know if it's as much of a problem anymore, but I'm not going to find out because especially the 25,000 kV motors. No. They're not getting stuck in my fucking hair. Those motors are crazy. Yeah, it's not a laughing matter anymore, dude. Those motors have... I don't get it. I do not understand how those Happy Model 25,000s make as much grunt as they do. It's just ridiculous. Super Deluxe, are you in Philly with Bot? Kristen wants to know. Inquiring minds want to know. Tiago, you bastard. Tiago sent $11 on PayPal, which puts us at 210. So we got about 10 minutes of life out of the switching the fund over to to the Cinesplorer. Thank you, Tiago. You are the man. All right, well, here, how about this? You guys pick. You guys have to, in the chat, how many people are in here? Oh, perfect. So 39 people in the chat. He said weed capital of the world. 39 people in the chat. You guys have to figure out what the next funding thing is. What do you guys want to see, right? What do you guys want to see me build that I don't already have? I don't, like, 7-inch toothpick? Sure. You guys pick. I'm gonna change the camera and get some work done. But yeah, let's see it in the chat. Somebody suggests something, and then somebody else suggests something else, and then get into a fist fight. I want to see fisticuffs over there. Alright, so that looks pretty good. Not bad. Okay, let's get some shrink wrap on it, and we can move on. Since they're both black, I'm just going to use double black shrink wrap, and I'll try my best to pay attention to not blow anything up. Which shrink wrap is going to go small enough? Try this one.
Yeah, it's perfect. It's perfect! I feel like I gave you guys a lot of responsibility getting to choose what I have to build next. Don't make me build, like, fucking Bodine Boatface or anything, please. Although, actually, fuck it, make me build Bodine McBoatface, because whatever you guys decide on, you guys are basically, like, a little, what the hell are they called? Jesus. You guys are a, where did it go? Here it is. a focus group, and you're, like, a perfect segment of the FPV audience, so, like, whatever you guys pick will probably be really good, because there are many more like you. You know what I mean? Look at that. Alright, cool. Just make... Okay, so I can't... No 10-inch mega, like, $1,000 shit. No 100-amp ESCs. There's, keep in mind that... budget, right? I'm unemployed. Keep that in mind. Don't hurt me. Oh, I mean, I'll just say no. But, oh, God! I forgot to tell you guys. They did a crazy flash sale on the, oh, I'm such a bad person for not telling you guys this sooner. Here, I'm gonna show you. There it is. Go to... Oh, wait. No. This is not what you do. This is what you do. You go to YouTube, and you search for Nick Burns. I am on this train. It is coming. Look at this, guys. Look. Ready? Go to Nick's video. And right here. Wait till you... Oh, God. I'm hitting all the wrong buttons. There it is. Ready? Click this. This is going to be the freestyle whoop. Look at that. Go. This is going to be the indoor freestyle whoop, I'm convinced. It's got the bigger props. It's going to have... That's going to make an actual measurable difference in float. And it's going to be lighter than... So I'm halfway through... I really need to finish this. But I'm halfway through taking the prototype newbie drone board and putting it onto a, what are these, the 75 frames, right? One size up. But it's heavier. This thing is going to be lighter because the, because of reasons. So this is going to be, this thing here is going to be a fat version, and then I'll be able to test it against that. And I'm pretty sure that's going to be better. Because it's just lighter. When you go to 85, they tend to gain weight. And this is going to be lighter because the frame is sucked in. You'll see. Go. Go. Is 95X the 2-inch prop? Teal'c? How do you pronounce that? Off-axis says build an R2-D2. Off-axis, make everybody browbeat Off-axis into making the R2-D2 fly. I laid the challenge down. He said no. He built a, what is it, like one-third scale? No, it's bigger than that. Half scale? R2-D2 out of 3D printed stuff. It's so cool. 85 is the 2-inch. Okay, yeah. The props that you want... Oh, motors. Oh, 95. 95 is 2.5-inch prop. You want the... There's a 4-blade prop. Oh, I got you covered. Oh, it's on Banggood. Okay, so I showed you guys that. Here's the... No. Go through Nick Burns' video so that he gets the... I can just copy and paste it. Here you go. This will make sure that Nick Burns gets the commission, because I'm sure that that's an affiliate link. On Banggood,
It is a 2435. If I remember this, I'm a effing genius. I haven't looked this up in a long time. These are what you want. The only thing that sucks is they're a 2.4 inch. They're not quite a 2.5 inch, but they're a four blade and they're bull nose. And those are the two things that ducts really benefit from. So, even though the whoop frame is not like a true duct, it still has a physical piece of material around the outside, which is what makes the bull nose work really well, and which is what allows you to run 4 and 5 and 6 blades without the usual efficiency decrease, right? The efficiency decrease to more blades is that on the end of the blade, you've got a high pressure zone and a low pressure zone, and then when the plastic blade ends, those two get all angry and get all turbulent and shit. That's why ducts work so well, is because you've now taken a piece of plastic and put it on the outside of the end of that blade, so that instead of those two high and low pressure zones mixing, they can't, because that piece of plastic is there. So you can make a 4-blade, a 5-blade, a 6-blade, and you don't really lose a lot of efficiency because of that physical piece there. So yeah, these Racer Star, here you go. These are what I think you want. If you don't run those, I mean, there's a million 3-blade options, but I don't know of any, is it really called the Suck Zone? there are a bunch of different props, but I don't think any of them are bullnose. I mean, if you just want something that's balanced, which is pretty important, like you should have a couple sets of these on hand, the Emax 2.5 inch, Rush prop is very, very balanced, and it's a great propeller, so just get some of them just to have. But let me grab my 2.5 inch prop bag. All right, so here are all of your options. If you guys can't tell, I just like, I don't know, man, I like propellers. I like playing around with propellers and trying different ones and seeing how they affect flight characteristics. well, this, maybe they won't blow up on you. Scour the internet, later off axis, be good, man. Scour the internet for, so this is the prop that they copied, that Racer Star copied to make that. God damn, can open. So these are made by Rotorex. I don't think Rotorex is around anymore, but this is actually a 2. So Racer Star went down to 2.4 inches, I guess, to get around, you know, copyright or whatever. But this is pretty much the same. This is what they copied, from what I understand. And it's, if this propeller failed because they made it to be either a biblade or a quad blade. Hey, there's the notification from PayPal. Thanks again, Tiago. so by making the hub so that it will do that and come apart like that, the hub is really weak. But a little Beta 95 is going to be lightweight too, so these will actually probably work. So this is Rotorex 2535? Yeah. RX2535. The collective is about to get on the scene. That I just typed in the chat what they are. Let's see who can find them, and call out the website. I think you guys will have a hard time finding those because they've been gone for a while. But I think that's what you want. Is these. Because of all the reasons that I just gave. I completely forgot about these. So like, to give you an idea, the other 2.5 inch prop options, these are bi-blades. That would be a terrible idea inside a duct. More bi-blades. These are the 2.3 inch Baby Hawk props. That would make no sense. These are, so HQ, well, yeah, these are kind of bullnose. So yeah, get some of these too, you might as well. HQ makes a 2.5-inch prop. Get a bag or two of these, just to test them, because they are kind of bullnose. They're somewhat bullnose. So yeah, give them a try. These are the Gemfan 2540s, and they've got, they basically added a winglet, like you see on commercial airliners, to try to manage the turbulence out there, and I'll bet you I can see that becoming a problem inside of a duct, but they are well balanced. It's a Gemfan 2540. These are very well balanced, so maybe dig around for them. And then here, these are the Emax Avan 2.5-inch Rush. Emax Avan Rush. These are very, very well balanced. With propellers, I really sincerely recommend that you guys just get all of them, like, in 2.5-inch. There aren't that many, and they're cheap, and it's fun playing around with them, and you learn different flight feels and flight characteristics, and I don't know, it's just fun. It's a cheap way of like, feeling like you bought something and getting, like, a little bit of retail therapy. You know what I mean? Sometimes it's just cool to, like... I had a bad day. Let me go buy 2 bags of props and have something to look forward to, right? I don't know. You're back. Ooh! And remember!
Did that go 2 times? It went around, didn't it? That's good to know. Weirdo, I haven't flown the folding props yet, but multiple people that I trust, have said that they're great. So they're great. I'm going to get some of the 6 and 7 inch eventually for the glide hammer. Because they're very, very light. For a 7-inch prop, the folding prop is extremely light. And that's one of the big problems with the 7-inch props is how heavy they are. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Alright, I think I'm caught up on the chat, right? Yeah, weirdo, it is hard to get ducts right. Stan FPV's got it figured out, but they're not, it's called Clam Man, Bearded Paddler. Clam Man. Or Asiatic Clam Man. I really hope that Stan FPV and Kebab working together will produce a molded Stan FPV prop, because a guard, because his guards are better than any of the other guards out there, but they're 3D printed, so they're just never going to be super durable. So yeah, I didn't even get them. I got the more durable PLA, not PLA, like molded plastic guards with the Cinesplore.
because I just know. I just know I'm going to blow those Stan FPV ducts up, and they're kind of expensive, so I don't want to get in the habit of breaking those. Extra for me. Do you guys figure out what we're doing for the next fund yet? What are you waiting for? Here, I gotta add it. What do you guys want to see me build next? You guys pick. It can be expensive. You guys pick it. There it is. That's barely legible. It's perfect. Did you guys already figure it out? You sons of bitches. That's like the one thing I don't want to do. I know I need to do it, though.
What?
Especially with the Cinesplore stuff.
Tearing a GoPro apart. Alright. Well, it could be an 8. We could pull an 8 apart.
We gotta be strategic about this. So here's the deal. I have a Hero 7 that, apparently the Hero 7 and the Hero 8 are the same durability-wise, which is, well, yeah, the Cineglide is for sure happening. Cineglide. I don't know about the Cineglide. Ugh. You gotta get popular opinion on that one, Brian. Rob Axon says build a Ciati-proof quad. Dude, the glide hammer. The glide hammer is absolutely invincible. It's ridiculous. I don't understand it. It's so incredibly stiff. But it's just a little bit too heavy, that's the problem. Like, I like the way that it's an extra 30 something grams, and it just feels big. I've got the 2407 motors on it right now, which help a lot. Like, it feels great with those motors, but they make it even heavier. So yeah,
I'm gonna shut just this one, and I'm gonna turn this on. That helps at all. This is my favorite shirt in the world. Look at that. That might be a winner right there. I might have just cracked the code.
Oh, that feels good. Alright, yeah, so somebody keep score. We don't have any... Hey, Guillermo! Oh, Guillermo says a car. I wish, dude. I can't expect you guys to raise that much. That's insane. And I like to try to keep it FPV related, you know? I think I might have missed a couple tags. So if I missed your question, anything above like Bearded Paddler saying what's that video called, or Rob Axelson and Weirdo's long messages, just tag me again if you don't mind. So you want injection molded ducts? The 3D printed stuff is really brittle because it just breaks in between the layers. Injection molding fixes that. It doesn't. I've got a hankering for some Asiatic clams. It eliminates that those weak points in between each layer when you injection mold. But I'll let you know. It's they're on the way. All right. Somebody take charge and figure out what. Jafar backing up MX-5 build or S2000. Never an S2000. I, man, at the The way that the S2000 lets go of traction in the rear can just eat me for life. I will struggle through MX-5s until the day I die, rather than dealing with the rear suspension geometry of S2000s. It's just not as good as the Miata. When you make them out of TPU, they immediately stop the propeller, and then it just desyncs and falls. When they make them out of the PLA, or I think he's printing them out of something else now, the propeller can at least, even if the prop bends in, the propeller can, keep going, so it doesn't just immediately desync. You didn't miss a thing, y'all, man, other than me putting the now filled up Cinesplore fund. Somebody needs to organize the masses here to figure out what the next fund is going to be. What do you guys want me to build next? I'm not going to help at all. It's totally on you guys. I'm looking for somebody to... if there was a moderator in here, I would drop it on them, but I might make one of you guys a mod real quick here. No, Jafar, I want this to be as unorganized as possible, to be honest. I want you guys to, like, yell at each other and shit. I like to try to, like, poke the chat like a fucking beehive and see if, like, you guys will start swarming and freaking out. No X-Class. No $1,000 builds. That's ridiculous. no $1,000 build. It's got to be within reason. Yeah, off axis got out of here just soon enough. Hey, there's a mod. There it is. Tiago's in charge. Tiago, you gotta organize it. Figure out what the masses want, and that's the next thing, the next fund we're doing. yeah, it's totally on you guys. I'll do whatever. iFlight Battle Axe. I haven't even heard of that. Drone pilot. I have an entire brushless 20-gram Whoop build all just sitting waiting to be built, and like everything else keeps getting in the way. But every week I'm like, this is the week, I'm going to do it Tuesday. Please, guys, do me a favor, bug the shit out of me to do the tiny Whoop build. It's going to be really good. I have like 3 different sets of motors to test. Somebody bug me. I got the BT 2.0 with the tiny Whoop batteries. It's going to be great. I got to do it. Bug me, please. Please bug me to do it. I'm the worst. The problem is I end up prioritizing 5-inch a lot. Because those rigs are just way more reliable, and they fly a lot better. So in terms of like trying to continue to get better as a pilot, those are the rigs to fly. But what I need to understand is that, and I mean obviously I do understand this, but I just need to get it through my thick dumb skull. Is that. That people don't want to see that because everybody does that, right? Not that people don't want to see it, but it's completely oversaturated. And there's a completely untapped market for like gnarly tiny Whoop flying, right? Like we've got SR-13, we've got a couple of the other tiny Whoop sponsored pilots, but like that's kind of it, right? I can't believe I just soldered 2 wires on here that are too short. You God damn son of a motherfucker. Oh, really?
Oh, I'll flip it. I'll flip it. I'll flip it. Got it. Got it. We're fine. We're fine. Oh, boy. Oh, and that actually works. That's the way the pads are on the ESC, left to right. Oh, I like that suggestion. Impulse RC Apex. That's a Ciotti approved. But don't let me... It's all on you guys. Totally on you guys. Don't let me influence this at all. Mike Bergman, I'm sorry, dude. I've been so tempted on like a dozen occasions at like 2 a.m. to just grab it, because it's going to be like a 20-minute build. But I told Beta FPV that I would do like an actual proper build video, so I don't want to just half-ass it. I want to actually do a half-decent job. But all that actually means is that I just need to make a... because I'm going to do it as a live stream build and flight thing, so all I actually need to do is schedule it, take a goddamn shower, and like make a thumbnail. Like that's really it. So please, somebody send me a box with dog poop in it and with a note that says, I will send one of these a day until you do the goddamn review, you strange, lanky, awkward man, you. Extra points if you use the word man-child. No, I can't. Okay, so I can't do the Apex with FETEC, because then I would be in the same situation as before, where I wouldn't be comparing apples to apples. The FETEC build has to be in a glide frame. Maybe after I do that comparison, and I don't know what to do with the FETEC stuff, because I'm sure that I'll end up liking Betaflight at the end of it. Again, because even without the bounce, well, I don't know if the bounce spec does go away in... So here was the big problem, right? I have that move that I always do that I absolutely love the look of, and but it is just a move that brings out bounce back. Like it's almost a perfect way of bringing out bounce back, and basically when I'm tilted forward, flying forward, I'll fly right past an object, and as soon as I go past it, you go full stick. If this is why I run matched rates on yaw, pitch, and roll, I go full max stick on both roll and yaw. And it makes the rig perfectly swing around, and the camera stays completely flat, and then you have all that momentum that you built up, and then you can float backwards, and it's just this like gorgeous move when you get it right. And it basically became like, okay, am I willing to not do that move anymore? And the answer was no. Like, I'm not willing to, you know what I mean? Like, I one flight software can do like an entire move, but it doesn't feel quite as crisp, maybe, although I don't even know. Like, KISS feels different. It felt different. It just didn't feel better. It just felt different. And different is interesting. So like, it was very hard for me to put that aside. And well, in the end, what I had to do was just look at my footage, actually. When I looked at the footage, the Betaflight footage looked better. And sometimes you get the feeling when... And it's funny because Joshua Bardwell said the exact same thing. When he flew that Steel Alien rig, it was him flying KISS for maybe the first time. He said, I feel like I'm flying like Steel. And he also said, I almost feel like a better pilot. And that's something that a lot of people that fly KISS experience, which I did. But when I watched, I mean, the footage doesn't lie, right? Like, feeling like you're a better pilot, maybe you could totally argue, come to think of it, that if it makes you feel like a better pilot, then you're gonna get more comfortable. And for me, all that really means is that I'm going to crash more and harder. And one of the other problems with KISS stuff is that it's expensive. Significantly more expensive when you start smashing it up. Right? Like, what's the ESC? $70 or $80? It's... And the flight controller is like 40, I want to say. It's just, you know, the FETEC stuff is still more expensive than regular Betaflight gear. So, although what we don't know is how durable it is. Maybe the FETEC gear stuff is completely invincible. It's actually something that I want to ask Krunkt, is whether Flyduino's gear electronics are better built and seem to hold up better than Betaflight. I mean, it's obvious that you can get Betaflight components that are cheap shit and will hold up worse, but you know, like proper Betaflight components, right? Like the Talon F7s, the Akon AK32. I wonder how the reliability compares. You know what I mean? Alright, so I'm gonna have to pop this beautiful little... Oh, and I fucking stuck it on there. Oh, man. I gotta get this up and off so that I can route this. I'm just gonna have to yank it. Well, I mean, not yank it, but... I always like to try to only stick sticky stuff once. Get it right on the first time, basically, because it's never the same. Never quite the same. All right, so this is good. We're just going to sneak this in right there, and then this bundle of snakes will push it out of the way, and I'm hoping that we'll have just the right amount of cable. What I don't like is that the video carrying bundle of snakes is on the same side of this. So what I keep trying to figure out is how I can put this capacitor on the other side. And I mean, I guess I could just pull that and that. Oh. Well, yeah. There's absolutely no reason to not put it on the other side. Yeah, because I just do this. What a jackass. You ever, like, think something is, like, I could, in my brain, I was like, no, there's no way I could possibly mount it on the other side, because all those antennas are in the way. Right? Like, okay. Problem solved? You know what I mean, though? You guys, is that just me? Like, I'll just have these moments where it's like, no, that's impossible. What? No. What? No. It's right there. Just do it. Why am I fumbling around like an idiot? This, you know what this doesn't happen with? 5-inch. Ooh, it's so fiddly sometimes. for anybody, the 16x16 is... 16 by 16 made me feel, more than anything I've ever worked on, that I've got the fattest fingers in the world. Like, I just felt like I just had thumb fingers. Just big, fat, sausage thumb fingers. Just all toes. Just toes, if you're a Community fan. My feet sewn to my wrists. That's what this feels like. It feels like I'm trying to use my feet to do this. And I've got a band-aid on my left thumb, which makes it, like, kind of slippery. Alright, this is getting... goddamn ridiculous. Oh, God! Thank you. Alright, now I just have to do it one more time. Can you guys even see what I'm doing? No. Those 3D pens are super cool. What?
What do you want to do for dinner?
Can you handle it by chance?
Yes.
Alright.
Because I wanted to cook the shrimp and I found out that it was stinky.
God damn it.
So I can't do that for dinner.
We don't have any pizzas left or anything?
I'm going to look in the freezer and see what we got.
Son of a... I can make beans on toast.
I have plenty. We have stuff. I just love it.
You guys don't know shit about beans on toast. Well, Weirdo does. Weirdo knows all about it. This is an odd song to come on. Let's get rid of this one. If you guys could even hear it. Oh, no, no Snoop songs. No Snoop songs. No. Oh, God. All right, there we go. That's better. feature goddamn life. I did it last night. Last night was my night. And we do need to know what we need. We got to go to the grocery store tomorrow, too. If not, we might actually die, right? If I don't get milk soon for those Oreos, I'm going to kill someone. So let's yeah.
We're supposed to fly today, so I was going to get shit.
We'll do breakfast for dinner
tonight. Oh, really? Oh, yeah. Perfect.
We'll do bacon, French toast.
And the scrambles.
No, I'm just going to do French toast, real breakfast.
Oh, shit. Okay, not homeless, not me breakfast.
Got it. You guys just learned everything you'll need to know about our relationship. one helpless man-child. One accomplished cook, designer, actual human being. that can survive on Earth. Y'all Man says put it under the drone. I don't know what we're talking about. The 7-inch. Okay, so now Tiago, you and Daniel have to work together to figure out what it's going to be, what the next fund is going to be. What are we building or swapping or testing? Right, it could be like all 1204 motors or all 120X motors, right? Like, what do you guys want to see? What is okay as far as what wiring you can run battery leads next to and what ones you can't? Fucking great question by Mike Bergman. Trying to avoid running leads out the back of a Marmot build, but I'm scared. Alright, so the only thing you care about is the video line. The yellow video wires are gold. You want to keep anything carrying VBAT as far away from those as possible. The big thing is the battery leads, though. It's one of the things that I weirdly like about the Speedix GS25. Like, in what world does putting the battery leads here in the middle of the board make any sense? Well, in a world where if you have to run... I mean, like, technically, yes, it would be better if they were all the way out here or up here so that you can rotate the board, but you can't always rotate the board. Sometimes you have to run the board front to back like this, and in that scenario, having these here so that you can run your video wire all the way on the other side is humongous. That's why this is on my recommended, you know, whatever... buy me list down below in the description. Hey! Yeah, that's one of the things I love about these GS25s. When somebody was doing a sale on these, and I think I bought like 5 of them at some point last year, and I've had them ever since, and they're just awesome. But they're really hard to find now, so that's what I'm checking out with this ESC here. This is the iFlight ESC. It's 35 amp, it's BL Heli 32, so it's more amperage than the GS25, which, I mean, yeah, I guess that's nice if you want to really go nutso, but these are really for micros, so you shouldn't be going too crazy on the motor and prop and battery setup, but, yeah, it's nice and small, which the GS25 is admittedly a little bit smaller, but this is still, hopefully, plenty small, for a tight micro build. That's kind of what, that's where the big performance jump is with micros, is when you go to a pain in the ass tight build where, like, the shit just barely fits together. That is unfortunately where you start to get really good performance. And if you think about it,
that's what a 5-inch build is. Like, it's slimmed down. It's a 5-inch freestyle build, I should say, right? Like, it's slimmed down. It only has what it needs. Yeah, there does seem to be a little bit more room inside of them, but they're still pretty... They can get pretty tight. I'm actually going to take one of the glides. Oh, I can't believe... I'm so happy I just remembered this. I had this thought when I was laying down, unable to sleep, of course, last night, and I almost got up and wrote it down, but I thought, you know what? I'll remember it, because... It's just, you're just a brilliant man, Aaron Ciotti, and, I have 15 millimeter standoffs, and I will bet you that one of these nano cameras, so I hang the cameras in the front of my glides off of TPU, front standoff loops, and those things are, you know, they're TPU, so they're all bendy, so you can, like, you can run a big fat camera, you can run a little tiny camera. Well, the nano cameras are now pretty good. The Phoenix Nano and my tiny trainer, from what I remember before it imploded, the feed was really good. I'm going to put one of those nano cameras in a goddamn glide, and I bet you I can drop that fucker down onto 15 millimeter standoffs. That is one of the big reasons why... I was so interested in the glide, and one of the things that Bob and I were talking about way back when is that by moving the flight controller, by using that... So for a cinematic rig, you want to push the camera forward, right? Well, when you do that in an alien-style frame, you create this big gap. And, like, a lot of people will put, like, a capacitor in that gap, but it's a gap that when you look at the way the camera has up tilt... there's more room at the bottom there under the camera. So in the automotive world, it's called packaging. You know, the engineers have to work with the styling people, they have to work with the safety people, and you end up with a box that you have a whole bunch of shit that you need to put in, you know, seats, steering wheel, airbags, electronics. So this is just packaging, right? And so it just kind of made sense to package the quad in that way. And when you do that, you just have a thin-ass flight controller, a thin-ass ESC, and then nowadays with the nano stuff, you know, like a Tramp and a Crossfire Nano aren't much thicker, and you can come all the way down to 15 millimeter standoffs, and that's going to make the frame a lot more durable, because 20 to 15 is... What's the percentage change on that? 33%? Right? So that's a 33% decrease in leverage on the standoffs, right? When you hit the top plate really hard, and the standoffs are the only thing keeping the two plates from getting all wobbly. So, yeah. What do you think about that? Give me a good nano camera, bro. We are off the rails and not getting any work done, but we're hanging out, and that's what's important. What are you guys talking about? My name is Orange. Hold on. Lots of orange that I'm just blatantly ignoring. I gotta get a drink because that granola bar was a granola bar. Here. Ooh, I got something for you guys. Check this out. I found a new one. And I need a minute. Here you guys go. We'll be right back.
right, enough of that. All right, Chris and I have a plan. We're moving forward with the plan. Gotta get caught up on the orange. Did it rain there today? Yes, it did, Daniel. It was a disgusting day, and I'm very sad because I really wanted to get out and fly. I woke up early-ish, 1 p.m., and I really wanted to get the ESC swap over into the glide hammer and just plow it across the parking lot at a million miles an hour. But the weather was shit, so I figured I would continue working on the Acrobrat here. Okay. Joint Pilot says, running video next to the capacitor leads is not the issue. The filtering effect is greatest anywhere along those leads. Yeah, I found that too. I was super worried about running capacitor leads next to the video wire. But last time I did it, it seemed completely fine. But I'm just sort of in this camp of, like, anything I can do to keep the video wire as far away from anything carrying VBAT, I'm going to do. And this, I'm really impressed. So that this is the first time I've had a micro board where it sends the leads up like this, and I'm kind of liking it. Like, you guys are kind of watching me fall in love with this board before your eyes. If there is, I can't imagine a nerdier thing to say in my entire life, but you know exactly what I'm saying. This board might be it, man. It's cheap. It's really cheap. I can't believe how cheap it is, and it's got BLE 32, and it's 35 amp, and it's... I think it also has current out. I think it also has a current output. Where's the... That, which is a big deal. None of the micro... well, I guess the new ones do. The GS25 doesn't have that, though. Where the hell did the little instruction manual go? Did I throw it away? Oh, no, it's up here. No, that's not it. I can just probably look at the number of pins and tell. How many pins does it have? 1, 2... 1, 2, 3, 4... Oh, yeah, it's got 8 pins. Yeah, so it has current, and it has telemetry out. Yeah, I mean, if this thing doesn't blow up, like game over. This is the one. What do you got there? Yeah, this is the one, man. This is almost as cheap as the great deal that I was getting on the GS25s. The GS25 was like a $45 ESC, but that was back when it was the only BL Heli 32 20x20 ESC. Cool Coyote asks, is there a way to determine that your processor is dead with a multimeter? Not that I know of. That is way above my head. That's a question for Joshua. He would totally be able to dig into that and give you an answer to that one. Daniel told me to feed my wife. Yawman Flight says, put it out the bottom. Rain there today. Okay, Mike Bergman. Why are everybody leaving that? Okay, good. Tiago, I think it's the naked GoPro. Okay. Yo-Man Flights, are you going to give away any extra screws? I need some. And put the capacitor out the bottom. Oh, I know what you're saying. I'm going to run it out. You'll see how I run it out because I don't have a lot of extra wire. Yo-Man, just message me what screws you need. If you guys need screws, message me. I have certain sizes of M2 screws I have a shitload of extra of. So if you need screws, especially if you've won something, if I'm already shipping you something, hell, if you win something and I'm shipping you something, if you need anything, just message me. Like, dude, do you have a Tramp VTX by chance? I need one tomorrow. You know what I mean? Like, just ask. But yeah, if you need screws specifically, just period. I'll just mail you guys screws because I can just throw them in a regular envelope and throw a stamp on them. If you guys need, like, I think, like, M2x7s, I have a zillion of. And they're just piled up in a thing. I'll never use them. Yeah, message me. Ciotti FPV is all over the place. Facebook, Instagram, wherever.
I'm starting to get backed up with messages, though, so if you don't hear back from me from a couple days, that it's, I'm not dead. I'm just, yeah. Ruby Sims says French, Europe says French toast, and you're shocked when it's not frozen French toast sticks in the toaster oven. Me looks over glasses, my guy. Yeah, exactly right. Yeoman and use landing pads on it. Dude, wait till you see what I have for landing pads for this. They're the sickest. Well, I will never remember that. So, it's actually got Tommy's logo on it. One of the guys in the Acrobrat prototype testing groups that I'm in made these with Tommy's exclamation point right in the middle. They work so well. They're just perfect. They're a little heavy. There was a while that I didn't run them and I ran foamy guys in the middle because that was lighter. And it was removing weight from the ends of the arms. But, yeah, I don't know. The Acrobrat is kind of heavy anyway, so fuck it. Why not make it worse? Ruby Tim says, are you going to buy your GoPro decased, or are you going to strip it down to its skivvies yourself, and you're going to do the Hero 6 so you can use RS Go? You better. All right, so it looks like it's going to be a... so now we need to figure out what we're going to do. So it could be an 8. So here's the deal, right? I have to get on the RS Go train, at least just to play around with it, or just have it available for if I do get a commercial-ish shoot. Athix, I saw your info. Thank you, brother. Remy says, flying from a boat, whoa, where did this footage come from? Why haven't I seen this before? It's amazing. Music. I guess you found that little, I just made a little super quick thing for the wakeboarder dude. We met him at Lake Lanier, and we went back out the other day, but we didn't get a nice, it was kind of just a practice trip. We're going to go back out with him again. He's going to bring like his five friends. He says his friends are like pro wakeboarders, so it's going to get pretty fucking dangerous. But yeah, hopefully the folding props won't cut too deep, because I'm going under someone. I hope those bindings are thick, man. Weirdo says you can fly a plane without a tail, so you can fly so can you fly a tail without a plane? William Barlow says still waiting on his winnings. Yeah, William, I think yours went out. The majority of them went out. I have a couple that I need to get back to because I messaged people that I didn't have their addresses. I'm going to try to get to them on Monday. Monday morning, I have to wake up and get going, and the giveaways have been a good way of my doing that for some reason. So, yeah. Mike Bergman needs M2 press nuts. Those I do not have, but you know who does? Beta FPV. Beta FPV on their website sells a bag of like 50 M2 press nuts. Ooh, Rugi has them on FPV cycle now too, I believe. Yes, he does. And you don't have to buy a big bag of 50, and you can get other cool shit off of fpvcycle.com. Put in the notes that Ciotti sent you, and that he should send me lots of free things. And then Rotten Tomato, have you thought about using landing rails in the center, using the unused mounting holes? It will at least center the weight of the TPU better. Wait, what? Why am I so lost? Get Ken Heron to spot for you. Brutal. Rotten Tomato, explain that in a different way. I can't wrap my head around that for some weird reason. I need to get this soldered on because otherwise I won't have done anything in this whole stream. I've been so distracted talking to you guys. There have also been some really, really great questions, so that's I love that. It's really cool to have an audience of people that is so knowledgeable and like ask good questions, like not having to answer what 3-inch should I buy is really nice. Like,
I don't know how. I don't know how Joshua does it. I don't know how any of the. And I've met and spent time with them, and they're not like. They're not cyborgs. Like I can confidently say that they're real people. Just like you and I. But, yeah, I don't know, man. They have this ability to just tolerate that, that I don't know if I do. I really don't. Which is my issue, not their issue, for the record. Ooh, buddy. Hopefully, that's not up too high, but I have a feeling it might be. Did it connect? Hold on. Please tell me it connected to that nice little blueby of solder there. Oh, it certainly did. I just need to knock that little edge off. Is it just me, or like every time that you solder on top of another wire, is it like... I feel like I'm fucking Indiana Jones in the Temple of Doom. Just like, don't push the fucking boulder. The whole thing will come off and it'll be the end of the world. You'll have to take 30 whole more seconds to restick it. It's only really bad when I, like, get it really good. Like, I got a really clean joint on this one. So that's... If it's not the cleanest joint, I'll kind of like, yeah, fall off, please. Please, give me a reason to redo you, bro. Oh, you fart bag. See, this is what I mean. Try to just clean it up a little bit. And we paid for it. I blame you guys on that one. Alright. Let's hit this one more time. And we're just going to go in and get out. Done. Sometimes you just have, like, yeah. I have a really weird mix of, like, getting it perfect because I took a second and I was calm versus, like, meh. Like, there are just... More often than I would like, I just go, meh. And that happens. And I know what it is. I know it's related to getting the... So there's, like, a pace to soldering. And the pace changes at different temperatures, and I just haven't done it. So you apply heat to the wire in this case. The wire takes the heat, the solder on the wire liquefies, then the heat starts transferring to the pad, and there's just like a speed that happens, and then at some point in that process, so the early part of that process, you still have flux, right? That's what the smoke is. And during that time, the heat transfers really well. Well, as soon as that smoke stops, the flux is burned off, and the heat doesn't transfer at the same rate at that point. So there's all these things that change the timing. Yeah, it's like I'm definitely a million times better than I was when I started 3 years ago, but it's interesting. Soldering, like many things, there's like a meta to it, right? Like that you only get to understand once you've done it for a while. It's the meta, I guess. So now we'll give them a little tug, make sure they don't just look good, but hold good, and yeah, we're set. Wow, that turned out pretty. Here. Let me give you guys a little zoomage. Here we go. Aethix, are you asking me if... Oh, you got a TS-100. Nice, dude. I am jealous.
I cheaped out and got the SQ-28, I think it is, and it's fine. It does everything. It's just not as fancy. It just doesn't look as cool, basically. I like the handle of it better, though. I think it's a more comfortable soldering iron to hold and to put down. You know, the main issue that I have with the TS-100 is that the body of it is so small that it's small with an O-L. The body of it is so small that I worry that, like, I would put it down and it would burn the desk. So this is all we've accomplished in the last 2 hours and 26 minutes. You're looking at it. yeah, the SQ body is bigger. And that just gets the tip up off the table more. So, I don't know. Maybe the TS-100 doesn't melt the table and it's not an issue and I'm just being insane, but... one of the reasons that I got it is to solder out on the coffee table, and we love our coffee table. Like, a couple years ago, when we were both, like I was well into my 30s, and, like, Kristen was getting into her 30s, we decided, like, all right, let's buy a piece of furniture or two for ourselves. Like, not as a present, not as, like, a hand-me-down, not as, you know what I mean? And we went to, and of course, like, I managed to find, like, a super crazy deal at World Market. It was, like, half off, and it was crazy. Kristen got all ninja with coupons, and, like, it was shockingly cheap. But we got this really nice mid-century mod coffee table, and I just don't want to ruin it. So. I should have probably gotten a TS-100, but whatever, I didn't. And it was cool to test. I got it when it was brand new, so it was nice to be able to drop it into my description. Like, yes, this thing is awesome. I have tested it. It's dope. Get it. Get two of them. Get three. Send me two. Keep one. Give one to your dog. Eat the next. All right, so we're good. We're done. Camera goes in. Poop happens, and then things fly. That's how it goes, right? That's the sequence. So let's get these little nutty boys on here. I'm gonna clean this one off a little bit. Oh god, you guys are still so zoomed in. I'm missing all the orange, guys. I'm doing a terrible job. Let me read Rotten Tomatoes' comment one more time. Oh, instead of TPU on the arms. Yes, yes, yes. That's a really good idea. The only thing is, so I did that. That's what I did with the foam feet, you know? Here, I'll show you. So basically what I did is I took two foam fetuses here, and I just stuck them. I think I put them right there. Yeah, because there's... Oh, that's what I did. I put one of them... I put three of them, because they really don't weigh anything. I put one of them wide, like this, right in the middle. And then I put another one... I think I just put one in the back, maybe. But lengthwise, like this. And the problem is, every time, like, you try to land, or like... It's all teetery and tottery, and like, just having them on the ends of the arms... Yeah. I love doing skids. That's the only reason for it, guys. I love doing skids. They're so stupid, and they rattle the shit out of your screws, and they're just so dumb, and they don't even look good through the goddamn GoPro, but they're just so fun. So fuck you for judging me. That I just want to do something that makes the performance noticeably worse, but allows me to do skids. If I want to do skids, I'm going to do skids. You hear me? Oh, I need, like, please. I would love it if you guys would judge me for that and make me feel bad about that, because it's just, it's horrible. I talk myself into and out of it, like, over and over again, because it's just dumb. But it's just so fun.
It is just so fun. And if you don't think it's fun, then I think you need to take your pulse. Because you're wrong. I don't know why it's so fun. It's just so fun. It's like you become a an RC car, a regular RC car for a minute. But then you can take back off again, right? You become an RC car and then like immediately you're like, "Well, this is boring." Because that's pretty much what happens to me every time I race a regular RC car. It's like a 3-second window and then I'm like, "Oh wait, I can't go up. Fuck this."
Oh, dude, it's yeah, it's harsh on everything. I do the skids on the foam pads now. You know, the real move is, this is the only thing I don't like about running the LEDs on the arms, is that, and there's a very simple solution to this, I just realized it, if you put the foam under the arms and then you run like a wrap or two of electrical tape, they're skiddy as hell, but they're foam, but they skid a bunch. But up until like 3 seconds ago, like you literally got to see in this tiny little screen over here, me have the epiphany that all I need to do is wrap the goddamn electrical tape under the LED race wire directly from the carbon arm to the foam. So that's now what I'm going to start to do. So, good stream. That's a problem that's been bugging me for a while. The Rotor Riot skids weigh 2.5 grams, and 2.5 grams is a lot of weight out on the end of the arm. 2.5 grams is also the amount of the weight difference between a 2306 and a 2207, and that weight difference is the main reason that I prefer 2306s over 2207s. So, yeah, that like 2.5-3 gram number on the end of the arm, I can almost promise you guys that you will feel that. I can almost promise you. And I'm somebody who has trouble feeling, like people say that they can feel the difference in latency between this camera and that. I can never ever tell stuff like that. Like I'll fly like Gemfan 5143s and then like the new V2S's and get them mixed up and think that I was flying one when I was flying the other. Like I think it's because I really do try to squash the placebo and or confirmation bias of going into something with like, oh, I know what HQ props feel like, or I know what Gemfan props feel like, right? I really, really, really try to squash that because it just destroys your ability to accurately review something. Cool Coyote says, how often do you desolder tiny components from boards? Never. I only ever solder wires to boards. To get the little tiny components, realistically, you need a hot air station to surface solder them. Typically, they just come right back off because you can't really like penetrate. It just doesn't, it's just not the same. See if somebody around you has a hot air station. That's what it's called. It's basically just a soldering iron, but instead of a metal tip, a little hose that shoots out really hot air. And then you just direct that tiny little section stream of hot air onto a component and it melts it heats up the whole area, right? Because it's air and it moves around in there. So it heats up like the little surrounding areas of solder. And then you can go in there with like a little pick and move the component back to where it needs to be. And then you remove the heat, the little heat jet thing. I only found out about hot air stations like, I'd heard of them and the name kind of made sense to me, but I never thought about what it would actually be. And then when we were at the big FAA rally in DC, one of the local guys, Sanaka, it was my first time meeting him, super, super, super cool dude. He brought a hot air station and I took one look at it and I was like, okay, like, it was exactly what I pictured. but yeah, it was cool to actually put my eyes on it and just like realize like, oh right, yeah, it's just a fucking soldering iron with a little tube with a jet of heat. That's the other thing. Weirdo said he really likes the TS-100, but the only problem is it's not heavy enough to do big wires. That's the other issue. Like, it's not heavy enough. It just... I don't know. For whatever reason, this... Okay. Yeah. Yeah, Daniel, skids are the worst. It's so bad. Like, the screws come so loose from it. Like, I never lost arm screws like I did when I had those skids on. It was like every battery I flew, there'd be another arm bolt missing. Like, what? I only skidded once. Like, how? Cool Coyote, I've saved a few boards by taking bits off of old boards and soldering them with my TS-100. It takes about an hour to get it right. Yeah, see, that's the other thing. When I get like 5 minutes in, I'm just like, nope. Jafar, I have a weird history of doing strange sneezes. It's something that I started doing in high school, my senior year. Because for whatever reason, I was like I was just like an unconscious passenger for all of high school. I didn't really have many friends. I just did what I was told, you know, just work hard, get good grades. And like, it's great that I did, because it kind of carried me for the rest of school when I did a much shittier job of being a student. But senior year of high school, I just decided, okay, I'm gonna become funny. And my father was a huge fan of David Letterman, and my father's sense of humor is absolutely incredible. So it was something that I could just do. And sneezing weird in a classroom it's like, you know, everybody laughs, and the teacher's like, you know, stop doing that. What, sneezing? No, sneezing weird. Well, that's just how I sneeze. I win. Right? Which, as a teenager, is, you know, the greatest thing that's ever happened to you in the whole 8, 17, I don't know, how the hell old are you when you're in high school? Probably far too old to be doing shit like that. But yeah, there you go. Learned a little something completely random and weird about me. That I'm sure you didn't care to know about. Alright, so we're good. I think we're literally done. We just have to plug the ESC into the flight controller and then tack the motor. I'm sorry, not the... Oh, well, yeah, I do have to start all the motors on. Yeah, just put the camera. The three camera wires onto the flight controller, and we'll be good. So I'm going to screw this ESC down, because we're good to go. Why have the allergens decided to... Nice, Daniel. attack me. That's pretty cool. Cool Coyote. That's pretty gnarly, dude. I wish I had the patience for that. I really do. I just, like, after 5 or 10 minutes, it becomes rage, and then, oddly enough, I don't get better at soldering when I get really angry and frustrated. It's the weirdest thing. Like, you would think that I would just immediately get way better, you know, when like, my hands start sweating and all I can think about is just lifting the board up above my head and just smashing the shit out of it on the desk. It's weird. I don't know. Maybe I was expecting too much. You guys are good sports for not calling the mental ward. Freelojo, see? Freelojo is in the loud, crazy, violent sneezing club. So what I'm doing here, so the
one of the other things that I really like about this ESC is that it comes with M3 holes. The GS25, the worst thing about the GS25, the Speedix GS25, is that it comes with M2.5 holes. Because what the fuck? So that's a real bummer about that board. I have to admit, I've never admitted that to you guys because, like, I feel like an asshole recommending that a board that is drilled for M2.5 because I know that someone else out there is going to realize that and go, what the f-? And they're probably going to go, what the fuck, Ciotti? But... And you can't drill them out to M3 because they run traces too close to them, which is a mistake that you only make once. Which I'm now realizing that I should have told you guys about. No, you know what? I did. I've said that before. I'm 99% sure. I should have that as a little note next to the link to the GS25. Oh, you know what? That link is probably broken. That board's probably gone. Why is this going in so far? What's happening here? Is this just gonna keep fucking compressing until the cows come home or what? Yeah, so this iFlight 35 amp BLH 32 comes with M3 holes and it comes with M3 to M2 soft mount grommets. And soft mounting your ESC is just a way to reduce a little bit of the violence, and there is a lot of violence on some of these crashes. It's gonna just space out the amount of time that the ESC has, much like what a boxer does, to not get knocked the fuck out. Like, if any boxer, like a featherweight boxer, if you close your eyes and he punches you, you die. Just because you're not expecting it, and he just hits your big head with all the force. Boxers don't die because they faint their heads back a little bit right before they get hit, and by doing that, it spaces out the amount of time. There's actually a there's an episode of Mythbusters about it where they test it, which is where I learned a bunch of this. But I mean, it's kind of simple physics anyway. But yeah, that's what these soft mount gummies do. So when it, you know, when hard carbon smacks hard concrete at 60 miles an hour and generates a G spike of, I don't know. That's actually a really good question. The onboard, you can set your OSD to give you a maximum G number at the end of the flight, but the gyros aren't designed to, you design like an operating range, and they are very obviously not designed to go up to like high G number, to read that high. So I think they're just like clipping or spiking or whatever. Because at the, like, after a big crash, it'll say like 2G, and I mean, that's bullshit. In car accidents with race cars at like big speeds, speeds that we can kind of get to ish. I'm trying to think. I think they get like up in the 100 to 200 G's on accidents, in accidents. But see, they have crumple zones and shit like that, right? Like, this is carbon smacking into concrete. What do you guys think? What do you guys think a G spike looks like on one of these things when they smack into concrete? 100 G? 1,000 G? Cool Coyote says, does the cap fit in one of the holes in the frame? It doesn't. It's so close, but it doesn't quite fit. You know where it does fit, though? Look at this. This is very tempting to do it this way. It fits in this center cavity. This is the way I did it at one point. And Patrick actually has his like this, but I actually prefer putting the receiver down in there. I think that's a little bit slicker because the whole stack is square. And I also, I don't know, having the capacitor poking out the bottom of the frame was just a little bit weird. So, changing it up for this one. And this will also get the capacitor away from stuff. And I guess it'll be easier to change it, too. If it was all buried in the frame, these capacitors do fail. I have had a number of these capacitors let go on me. So, usually it's when I wire them backwards, but, you know. FPV is hard, man. There are moments in this hobby where I'm just like, really? Still? You're still making that mistake? I was out flying the other day, and I had that moment. I did something. I'm like, really? You've been doing that stupid ass like movement and telling yourself how dumb and like overused it is for the last like 4 months of flying. I'd mentioned yesterday, well, last night actually, that I'm I don't know. I don't want to make a big deal out of it, but like, I'm trying to like shift my style. Sounds so weird to say it, but like, I don't know. I think we all have like a style of flying, and I am just kind of trying to shift a little bit to be more. I don't want to be a one-trick pony. I want to be able to be as, I don't know if versatile is the right word, but I want to be able to fly like Drib or like Steel or like both or like Johnny or like Window Washer, right? Like I don't just want to be a like, you know, hey, he can only fly like that. Because incorporating other people's kind of styles and or flow opens my eyes to things that I can do better in my own, I think. Is kind of where I'm coming at it. Like other people have spent a lot of time figuring out the move set that they've got in their repertoire, right, in their toolbox. So, if you watch them, you can save some time by kind of going off of what they've already figured out, right? Does that make sense? I think that makes sense. And it's fun. It's very, very fun to fly it in a new, different way. It just forces you to keep growing and experimenting. Which, like, it's just such a different creative. It's we're able to move a camera around in a way that only game designers have been able to, right? In the last, I don't know, how long have game designers had full 3D control, do you guys think? 20 years? 30 years? Right? That they've been able to move a camera around, but it's just, it's never been a thing in real life, right? I have to take this out. I keep trying to straighten this bolt. Oh god, you guys can't see anything. I am the worst. Sorry, guys. These streams are 99% podcast anyway.
I'm making French.
Alright, cool. I'm gonna wrap up then. Give me those last minute questions. Oh god, $5 super chats. We're gonna do a super chat giveaway for all you awesome people that stayed to the end. $5 super chats to get in on a
This is the Caddx Baby Turtle. Caddx Baby Turtle. Wait, no, hold on. We got to make sure we're over 40 people. 45! Ha! Okay, yeah, so $5 Super Chats. If you do $5, I'll put you on the wheel once. If you do $10, I'll put you on the wheel twice. If you do $15, I'll put you on the wheel 3 times. If you do $20, I'll put you on the wheel 4 times. If you do $25, I'll put you on the wheel 5 times. Yeah, Caddx Baby Turtle. It's used, but it still works totally fine. No physical damage. Nah, the plastic on the button has like a little, like, it looks like the world's tiniest hamster kind of chewed on it, but it doesn't affect the button in any way. Yeah, it's this is the Tiny Whoop dimensions, and then this is the Nano 14. If you do $100, you are the wheel. 14 millimeter wide camera. So this is cool for Tiny Whoops, or I had this in a Tiny Trainer. So if you want to build an HD Tiny Trainer, I no longer have an HD Tiny Trainer, so you'll be very unique. I know there is at least one other one in the world, though, for the record. There's also one with a Caddx Vista in it, by Mongo. But yeah, $5 Super Chat, I'll put you on the wheel, and somebody gets it. I think these are 80, no, can't be 80 bucks, 60 bucks, 60-ish, I think. All right, so, and time's running out, so hurry, ha! So that's wrapping up, that's discharging. What's 11.4 volts in 3S land? 11.4 divided by 3 equals 3.8. Hey, storage voltage. Fantastic. There's one of the Tiny Trainer batteries discharged. Now I don't need to discharge them because I'm able to fix it. Okay, great. Well, at least we pointlessly bled off energy from one thing to another. Freelojo wants it. Look at him. I see what you said there, Private. I see it. Okay, I need a replacement screw for that horribly bent one that I just... I'm very glad that I finally gave up on it. I didn't get it out yet, though. Which one is it? It's the one that wobbles like a crazy person. Okay, so, what length is it? Is the question. And it's one of these darker ones. These are like close to being the same length, but not quite. No, that's a lie. Okay, good. This one's gone forever. Get out of here, bent M2. Yeah, for anybody who didn't know it, M2s do bend. Like, it is an issue. Going from M3 hardware to M2 hardware, it's actually kind of surprising how much weight you save, but don't think you're not going to lose durability. Like, they are much less durable. I haven't done it on a 5-inch yet. I haven't gone down to M2 hardware and run it for a long time to get any like real... Although it shouldn't... I mean, some micros will go just as fast, and speed is what the amount of G is going to be like put through. That's not... words became very hard just now. Words hard. Hard words. Remy Tim needs motivation to try micros, and micro HD gear will help. There it is. We've got 4 entries into the Caddx Baby Turtle wheel spinning fiasco. $5 Super Chat will get you on the wheel and get you, as it stands, a 1 in 5 chance to win a Caddx Baby Turtle, which is like $50 or $60 or $70 Tiny Whoop sized board with 14 millimeter camera. And the HD from it is shockingly good. Like, I'm legitimately blown away by how good the HD out of it is. It's not a GoPro session, but you can't expect it to be for, you know,
1/8 the price and a wacky form factor from a company called Caddx. Right? But you can make a Tiny Whoop with the damn thing. Like, you can legitimately build right now a fully 1080p Tiny Whoop with this silly little board bolted on top of an AIO. And that is pretty cool. If we could have done that when I was super, 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 super hardcore on micros before 5-inch land, I probably would never have gone 5-inch. Because that was the reason that I went up to the 5-inch rigs, was to get HD. If there would have been any way of getting HD back then, I would have been on that shit like white on rice. Ugh, that was the dream back then. I was so goddamn jealous of Brad, because he built 5-inch rigs way, 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 way before me. But what's interesting is not having HD as a new pilot just kind of ended up making me fly more. Instead of like watching footage back, I ended up just spending all my time flying. And what's interesting is, like, when you're just starting off like that, even though at the time you think your footage is good, when other people watch it, they get nauseous because you keep correcting. At least for me, for the first 6 months, like, all I did was correct back and forth and back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. I had no ability to just not touch anything. And, like, if you're looking for a secret to fly the way that I fly, the only actual secret is don't touch anything. Like, touch the controls, but then don't touch them for as long as possible, or leave them in the same spot for as long as possible. Because when you do that, the audience can look at the actual environment that you're in, and they're, like, becoming immersed in the environment, rather than becoming immersed in, like, 18 things swinging back and forth and flipping and flopping and going upside down and backwards. Steel's ability to fly like that but have it still be watchable is pretty fucking amazing. That like, to me, I think that's the thing that impresses me most about the way that he flies. But wow, I don't remember where that fucking rant started. But William Barlow is on the wheel twice. Bad Habit RC is getting on the wheel once. Brian Ladmiral is getting on the wheel. In case anybody just came in, Caddx Baby Turtle, 14mm camera, Tiny Whoop board, 1080p, 60 I think. $5 to get on the wheel. $10 to get on the wheel twice. $100 to get on the wheel 20 times? Yeah, 20 times. The problem is I know how to do math, but I doubt myself. Every time I go to do math, I'm like, nah, there's no way that's right. There's no way you remember that from when you were a kid, basically, is what I'm saying to myself. Where's that flight controller? Here it is. All right, I'm going to give you guys another couple minutes. I can hear things happening in the kitchen. And we'll do the giveaway. We will jump up and down. Oh boy, that gets really close. I think I'm gonna put a 1mm washer on there, because that USB port is all up on, oh God. Sorry guys, oh boy. Boy, if you buy 20, you get one free. Abso-fucking-lutely. Oh, absolutely. Hell, if you buy 10, you get one free. I will lowball myself, gladly. So what I could do is desolder these two motor wires
and flatten the wires out a little bit more, and then just specifically like make sure that I get the wire completely flattened out. But instead of that, I'm just gonna run a spacer because I have enough on top here. So I've got enough height, and moving the flight controller another millimeter away from the ESC is just, there's just nothing terrible about that idea. Like, there's nothing bad about doing that. That's only a good thing. If anybody wants to PayPal me for to get on the wheel, so that YouTube doesn't take the 30%, just make sure you tag me and let me know that you PayPal'd me. Because it takes a minute or two to come up on, as a notification on my machine. Allergies. Why you no leave me alone? Ah, stuck in trees. Yeah, man, that's that is the harsh reality of this hobby. That is what will keep the non-fully committed lunatics out of this hobby, though. So we will always be, we will never be the craziest people in the room. It's really one of the great things about this hobby, in my opinion, is that not only is the barrier to entry kind of rough, but staying in it is just as rough, and it will weed out the non-lunatics so that just us crazy people can hang out. Just us fully torqued folk. And I'm just compressing this a tiny little bit more so that everything is gonna... Oh, you know what I should check? I should check to see if the flight controller is gonna sit flat. Because if there's any... What I'm worried about is the I don't screw these nuts down in a way that they're even. So I can check that by putting the flight controller down here and seeing if it wobbles, right? Because if it wobbles... on either diagonal, that means that, so it does. So you see that it wobbles more on this side than from this diagonal. So that means that either here or here is too high, or both. So it kind of looks like, so these two guys are a little bit too high. So let's fix that. You guys want the last 1%? You got it. Here it is. That one already looks pretty squished. This one doesn't look as squished, so I'm going to give this one a little bit more. Luckily, all of these things that we're doing will stay. These will not vibrate out of this adjustment that you're doing. That's why I'm willing to do this. So now that should sit down there a lot more flat, just from that tiny little bit, because it wasn't off that much. So we're going to put that flight controller back down, and again, we're going to try to rock it on its diagonals. And we're going to see if it wants to stay flat. Well, basically, I'm just comparing one direction to the other. Because I really don't, there's no way to know how much the rubbers are really going to compress, right? So it actually still seems like there might be a little more wobble in this direction. So I'm just going to give this one more tiny little tighten, and then we're going to move on, because this is really like lunatic level micro-building. But unfortunately, this is what's required to get a fully torqued donger. Wait, no. This is what it takes to get a... For anybody that doesn't know, that's not me being insane. That's, I'm quoting Cole. I'm quoting Workaholics. All right, we're going to do the giveaway. $5 to get in. You guys got like 30 seconds to get in on this giveaway before I spin the wheel. 30 seconds, $5 gets you on the wheel. You can win a Caddx Baby Turtle, which is a whoop-sized 26 by 26 board with a nano 14 millimeter wide camera. 30 seconds, $5 super chat.
Or 10 if you want to get on the wheel twice. 20 seconds. Better hurry. I see you. I see you. You know you want to do it. Just do it. Just do it. It's going to a good cause. It's going to, oh, I forget what we're even funding now. What did we say? Oh, the decased GoPro. Yeah, yeah. It's going towards the decased GoPro. You know you want to see some gnarly decased GoPro cinematic dongers coming at your face. I'm going back to that well. I don't know why, but I am. And the little brass bastards are here. And that's going to be the final assembly on the stack of this Acrobrat duo. So look, we did do something in this stream. Jeez. Took 3 hours to solder a capacitor on and to figure out how we were going to mount the stack. But you know what? We did it, and it's done. And the end of that screw is kind of mangled. All right, I'm going to put you guys in the wheel and spin it, because it doesn't look like anybody else wants to get in. So let's roll to the left and push some buttons. Come on, thing, get on there. God damn. The end of the screw is just jacked up in some weirdo way. Oh, and that just like loosens itself too. That was a little weird. Oh, it's because I was spinning this on there. God damn it. All that adjustment I did just went out the window. Well, I'll redo it when you guys aren't watching. Ooh, that's annoying that I just did that. It was a... Yikes. All right, here we go, guys. Scrolling back up, we've got... Where's a wheel? Give me a wheel. Wheel of Decide. There's the Wheel of Decide. We're going to go Free Lojo. And then we're going to go Daniel Maurer on the wheel 3 times. Copy, paste, paste. And then we're gonna get a little bit of William Barlow on twice. All right. And then we've got a little bit of Bad Habit RC action happening. Why am I not? I really need to learn and remember that I can copy and paste. And then we've got Brian Ladmiral. I think that does it. All right, yeah, we're good. Unless somebody sent PayPal, but I don't see that anybody tagged me and said that they did. Let me just real quick double check. All right, now we're good. And wheel, here we go. Advanced options. Big wheel. There it is. The wheel changes have been applied. And... who it gonna be? It's going to be Free Lojo. I can see it coming. Ooh, he gets in there and steals it from the rimmiest of Tims. Free Lojo, congrats. Do me a favor and shoot me a message on Facebook with your first and last name, address. Tell me what you won and your email address if you would like tracking info. That's going to do it for me. I'm going to go eat. Thanks for hanging out. The next time you see this, it'll probably be done. because I'm probably just going to bash through it when I come back from eating tonight after Kristen goes to sleep. And I can't fall asleep because I can never fall asleep. I'll see you guys on Discord. Jump on the Patreon page if you're not already, because you're going to fucking love it. And wish me luck for having hair that looks this awful. Oh, and remember.
諦めんなよ!諦めんなお前! どうしてそこでやめるんだ、そこで!もう少し頑張ってみろよ!ダメダメダメ!諦めたら!周りのことを思えよ!応援してる人たちのことを思ってるのって!あともうちょっとのところなんだから!俺だってこのマイナス10度のところ!縮みが取れるって頑張ってんだよ!絶対やってみろ!必ず目標達成できる!だからこそ!言えば